getting chilly up here.
First real stop is in Sparks, Nevada. Stopping for gas. This 66 Plymouth has no overdrive, so he's gonna be drinking fuel a lot quicker than we will be. Bryce has got a Viper 6-speed in his car net, so he gets way better mileage than non-overdrive cars. So. We're in Carlin, Nevada now. Stop number two.
That one a dart or a scam?
That's a Plymouth Fury, 68 Fury, yeah. So far everyone's doing great. And the gas is way cheaper here than it is in California. So hooray for Nevada. So we're gonna go find some lunch and keep on trucking. I also would like to point out the disgusting number of crickets. Those are all dead crickets on the ground there. And these boys are massive. Big crickets. Disgusting. Wendover, just about to cross into mountain time, and Utah. Utah state line, here we go. Lamo, Utah. And what's one thing in Utah? Bonneville. That's
Mormons.
What?
And Mormons.
And Mormons. Bonneville and Mormons. That's what's in Utah.
Welcome to Utah, boys.
That's where we're heading. Bonneville, not the Mormons. Quick stop before we get to the Salt Flats. The There they are. There is the salt. It's all right there. It's even on the ground. I'd rather look at salt than crushed crickets.
So. I wouldn't put all this rust.
Yeah, true. But it's less gross than crickets.
It is much less gross.
All right, we're out here at the Bonneville Salt Flats. We got our stuff lined up all cool-like. But I think my favorite feature about the Bonneville Salt Flats, look how expansive it is. It just goes on forever. But that is my favorite feature. Thank you again, Ricky, for putting that there. I was going to put another one up, but I might not have to now.
Hey, I know that kid.
I just had to place one for myself. No, actually, I don't like that spot. Right there. Right there. So, I put that one. Ricky put that one there. So, I've been to the salt flats. How cool. One of the drive, Best Western in Colville, and Canadian Andrew is here. We're all very tired. He's got a right-hand drive. Subaru. And Bryce is giving us a show now.
A cowboy's questioning your sexuality.
But we're here, and I think we're all going to sleep good tonight. Right hand drive from the Boost Barn.
Like 1800 RPM?
Something like that, 1800, 1900 RPMs. Good morning. It is day two of our drive to power tour. And had a wonderful night at the Best Western here. And where are we? Colville?
Colville,
Utah.
Utah.
Cars all made it. No problems. Andrew is here. Met us here with his Subaru, and getting ready to hit the road for another 6.5-7 hours of driving all the way out to where are we going? Wyoming? Kansas?
Nebraska.
Nebraska.
Kimball, Nebraska.
All right, that's where we're gonna be. And we charged up this GoPro, so I won't have to use my phone anymore for this, so hopefully the images will be better. All right, first stop of the day. Drove a grand total of about, I don't know, 100 feet from the Best Western over to the gas station. Oh, that was an exhausting drive, but we're gonna juice up and hit the road. The gang's all here. And I thought I saw a Dodge behind the bathroom. Ooh, I did. I'm gonna just go take a peek.
Going down the line and I get
Ooh. It's got an emergency light. This must be like a snow truck or something. Oh, wow, this truck has seen better days, but I suppose that's how they do things up here in the Utah. Long bed, been beat to hell. Oof, that's really bad. But, oh, that's, yeah. Still, pretty cool truck. In the middle of nowhere, Wyoming. Stopped for a pee break. Get a look at some of these beautiful rigs here.
Dude, it sounds like fucking shots off at us. Just like, yeah, it's pretty fucking.
It's like bang bang. I'm like, oh fuck.
Did you get the shot? Get some real.
Some bad looking automobiles. I'm really loving Alex's 68 Plymouth. I don't know why, but it's just super rad.
Just dusting us out.
Thank you.
hanging it out there in the rally car. Nice.
Hold on, I gotta get this.
Yeah, get some pictures of that. Probably can't see it in this video, but Andrew's out there tearing it up with his Subaru.
His what?
Subaru.
Oh, I thought you said Subaru for a second.
Look at this mad lad. Oh, sideways action. Here we go.
What a madman.
Yeah, it was nice to hear. So,
where's the fucking pothole that I just annihilated?
That one? Right there. That is a pothole if I ever saw one. You came at the pothole full force. So Bryce tried to be cool and rip around the corner here and hit the pothole, and I wasn't buckled up and my head went into the ceiling. That was fun. But here we are at the Great Divide. Looking good as usual. Bryce is over there vlogging. And it is really windy. Andrew's over there being by himself. Whole lot of nothing out here.
It's like hitting skates.
I don't know what it is.
I think it goes like...
It's a souvenir.
I went to like right where that first station is and it keeps going.
Souvenir right there.
Good idea. Ho! Come on, boys! Let's hit the road! We left LA on Sunday and then Lubbock by Tuesday, and that's where we played our second show. Where nobody knew us, so nobody noticed the songs that the band didn't know. Well, eating up in white lines.
All right, it's day number three of the drive to Hot Rod Power Tour. And we're out here somewhere in Nebraska at the Hamptons. Not sure where exactly, but we had a bit of a snafu last night where Bryce's throwout bearing is leaking fluid. We're not sure if it's from a fitting or if it's maybe from the bearing itself. So that's not good. We're gonna try and fix that today at Napa or some auto parts store nearby. So, yep. But other than that, things have been pretty good. All the other cars are doing good anyway. But hopefully this won't be too bad of a fix. While the time lapse is running, I'd like to give a shout out to Panhandle Auto Group in Sydney, Nebraska for letting us use their lift. They're the shop that graciously opened their bay door for us and let us work for a couple of hours while we fixed Bryce's transmission. While we were there, we also balanced a couple of Alex's wheels on his 68 Plymouth. The owner's son, Jaron, was there and he was very helpful. He brought us tools and gave us what we needed to fix Bryce's car and get on our way. So thank you again, Panhandle Auto Group. You definitely saved our bacon.
There it is.
I'm gonna leave for now.
Nice.
Thanks.
Yep.
Big old split and
O-ring.
Holy
shit.
The O-ring split?
Yeah.
What the farmer's fuck?
Okay. Here, I'll get a pick.
Well, I can ask Drew because he said if there's any like part store fixes.
How does that even happen? Is there like a...
Well, because we're on Power Tour, Bryce.
Well, I'm okay. Besides that, is there a nick in there? Otherwise,
yellow pick. Ooh. Right there, I can see the big old slit in it. There is
light. Ooh.
There's yeah. The source.
Let me get
do
a,
it.
She's pretty warped.
That's, yeah.
That is very warped.
That'll do it.
A little silicone should be fine.
See that?
That's your foot.
That is your foot.
Just kidding.
How? That doesn't make sense.
So random.
Is there like a tractor supply or
just
something
heat,
around
maybe?
Here?
Okay, what time is it?
Anomaly sometimes.
You got 30 minutes.
You have Napa till noon.
Do you guys have O-rings here?
Napa till noon, it says four.
Why till
is
noon?
Four, I think.
ENS is new.
ENS?
We're dead.
We're dead.
Okay, that's fine. So
we're all dead.
Let's make sure the internal one isn't
welcome
fucked
to help.
Too.
We're all dead internally.
No, I've got another battery in the...
Anyone?
In the car. Go get that battery.
Mush.
Just kidding.
Oh, dude, your clutch is drier than...
Oh, no.
I don't want to climb up there and pop.
You don't have to buy a clutch.
I don't know what I'm comparing to, but it's completely fine. There's nothing wrong with
it. It's dry.
It's drier than my great-grandmother's back.
Okay, you said it.
Nice.
Drier than the salt flats?
I said that. I said that.
That.
My great grandmother's wow. That. It's just down in the garage. Dry. Yeah, that's. How?
So here's what it rides on. Here's the.
Yeah.
There's the shaft.
Don't ask me why I was good at that. Okay.
How's that O-ring inside there?
That one's fine.
That one's
it's
fine.
Just the back. The back one's just blown out for some reason. I don't know.
You blow out the back.
Yeah, yeah. Wait, where is
it? Oh,
you
can see. Oh, it's in the camera bag in the back with me, I believe.
The green one.
So I don't know if when we install it, this thing pushed a little too far forward. I think. I never
mushroomed it or something.
I've only ever installed like the constant velocity throwout bearings.
Yeah.
Never,
it could be
like
that
battery.
Right
no, it goes that way. So when we installed it, it might have sucked this forward too far. It's, this might have to go on first, and then you press that on there. We might have.
Did you guys lube it before you put it on? That could be the other thing.
I mean, I thought I put some anti-seize on it, but I wasn't in charge of putting it on. Like,
well, you don't want to. You don't put anti-seize on.
I did not.
I would put straight up brake fluid on it.
Yeah.
Because they don't like. Like if you're assembling calipers and you do like WD or anything like that, it actually beats the O-rings when it mixes with the brake fluid.
Oh, good to know.
So you always want to just put whatever fluid you're using hydraulic. Good.
Just spit on it.
Pour some liquid death in there, it's fine.
That's, it's water.
I'm looking at the horizon. I'm an innocent man looking at the horizon.
Hey, I'm short, all right? My shorts can be short.
Clean it up, put an O-ring in.
Nobody can see all of
you. Okay, so what do we got? Napa, there's a hardware.
It's an S&S.
There's an
E&S.
Supply.
Auto supply has
to the Subaru.
And then one.
They're showing
Super Goose.
Super Goose.
I'm gonna wash my hands real quick.
Yeah, maybe we take this with us too.
Yeah.
Through that door there.
So we just need some like emery cloth or something just to.
It's got a.
Because like you can see right here, that's probably where it cut it.
Yeah.
So.
How the fuck did that?
Some emery, something really light.
Do you want some emery cloth?
Yeah, some emery cloth would be awesome. And right here too.
Emery, just, yeah, emery cloth or like freaking 2,000 right grit sandpaper.
Yeah, it looks like the O-ring.
Yeah, that's cool.
Slid itself right on that. So I don't know how that happened, but.
I mean, it's got marks all over this thing.
It was just trying.
I'm just glad it's got. Chewed on it before he put it in.
Ty lubed it up.
Put it, in, put it in his mouth.
Yeah.
That'll do it.
Who needs tobacco chew when you've got O-rings?
O-rings.
Exactly.
Ladies and gentlemen, super awesome update. So we
super
are
awesome, sort of.
Actually in a shop. So let me get a little bit more out. Okay.
Yeah.
I think that should be. Yes. Got it. We in like Flynn.
Although I don't know who this Flynn guy is. What the hell was he in?
What? That's fine.
That's mine.
It is.
How are we doing over here? Are we having a wheelie good time?
Not at all.
Sure.
This wheel is just
junk.
Trash.
Now, because now we're scraping weights off.
For the second time.
For the second time. Oh boy.
Am I making that
sound? Junk.
So. All right, time for a little rip and dip around the block.
Looking car. Alex has got his Corvette here all broken down.
Bless you.
With a wheel that cannot be balanced. And he never came back.
And he drove out by
the house. There goes my hero.
All right, we are still in Sydney, Nebraska. Got Bryce's transmission fixed, so no more leakage. We're all lunched up, and we're gonna finally hit the road onward to Missouri. And it's raining, so that'll be fun. Again, gas is cheap out here. $2.87, $2.97 for unleaded. Oh, wish we had that in California.
All right, it is day number 4 of driving to Power Tour. We stayed at the Econo Lodge. Yeah, it was okay. The bedroom smelled like motor oil. We got in at like, I don't know, 2:30 in the morning, because no one around here had any available rooms except for the lodge. And we were all very tired because we had to make up for the lost time that we had when we had to fix Bryce's transmission. So, yeah, we're finally on our way to Bowling Green, Kentucky. Last stop for us, first stop for Power Tour. And that starts tomorrow. So, yeah, time to go get some breakfast. What's this, the final day of our drive?
Final day of Bowling Green, Kentucky. We are being absolutely spoiled right now because the weather is really nice. I would say it's maybe 68 degrees outside, if that.
And, yeah. 64 degrees. It's nice right now.
It's freaking gorgeous right now.
Because last time I was here in Missouri, it was spicy.
It was like salsa. It was wet.
Wet and hot?
Wet and spicy.
Yeah. No, we're doing pretty good right now. So, more driving ahead. St. Louis Arch, and wow, is it tall. And hopefully we're gonna go walk under it.
Yeah, that's a lot of metal.
That's a lot of metal. Pedal to the metal. And here we are.
That's freaking cool.
So yeah, cool.
St. Louis, pick up Craig, hop back on the road, and the rest of the way to Bowling Green.
Gateway Arch National Park in the Holy Wow. Almost doesn't even look real.
But it could be.
That's a lot of metal.
Yeah.
I don't know who did that, but I
kind of want to jump off it into the water. The river's right over there.
I'm sure someone's jumped off of it with a parachute.